Hi everyone, and welcome to A Writing Guy YouTube channel. In this channel, I create videos mainly on fountain pen and topics that piques my interest, as well as my other hobbies using 4K content. If you like what you see, please consider pressing the like button, or even better, subscribe to the channel for future content. In this video, I'll talk about the things I've learned after reading the book The Richest Man in Babylon by George Clason. I've had my fair share of financial mistakes in my youth, and especially critical mistakes when it comes to fountain pen purchases. In this video, I would like to share with you the things I've learned and starting to apply into my life in order to improve my financial situation and to prolong this fountain pen hobby in a more sustainable manner. A lot of us, especially millennials, do not have the financial literacy to be able to act upon a paycheck to sustain our current lifestyle. By the mistakes of impulse purchases and not saving enough money for an emergency fund for the rainy days. And I quote, "The first law of gold. Gold cometh gladly and increasing quantity to any man who will put by not less than 1/10 of his earnings to create an estate for his future and that of his family." This advice emphasizes on living below your means and to start saving in case of an emergency, and also as the first step to start building your wealth. And in the case of the fountain pen hobby, it doesn't mean that you cut out pen purchases entirely, but space them out and give great consideration before pulling the trigger on any pen purchases, so that you don't have to regret getting that pen later on, or have to sell it off because you needed the cash. I personally made a lot of purchasing mistakes during my college years, thinking that I was still young and still were able to make more money as time goes on. And there were nothing to be worried about. It definitely came back to bite me, and now every single month, I put aside a small amount as my fountain pen budget, and it really helps to slow the urge of getting a new pen on my list, and also make me think critically about my purchases. A question I usually ask myself before pressing the buy button is that, given the pen in question and a stack of money of equivalent value on the table, which one I would pick? And to my surprise, about 9 out of 10, I choose the stack of cash. Even though lately I've been thinking really hard on the Pelican M805 Stressman, those silver strips are mesmerizing. Please let me know down below your previous buyer's or seller remorse, as well as impulse purchases that turned out to be the best ones you made in your fountain pen journey. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.